Lord Ethan, as I was saying, you are young. And there are those within these walls who are uncertain of your leadership. But 300 generations of Forrester lords stand behind you. Lord Gerhard the Tall, who founded our house, and your grandfather, Lord Thorin the Bold, who seized back the river valley from the White Hills.
What did they call my father?
Lord Gregor the Good. He was fair and wise, and courageous in battle.
I want to be like that, like my father.
Your father was well regarded by nearly everyone. It took years, if not decades, to earn. These were your father's people to lead and protect, and now they're yours. But your father did not bear this responsibility alone. He and every Forrester lord before him chose one man whom they trusted above all others, the Lord Sentinel. Forrester traditions demand that a new Lord Sentinel must be chosen.
Keep walking, you craven son of a whore. Move!
Oh no.
Summon the Lord! We need his judgment!
Oh fuck! Judgment on the second day?
I've done nothing wrong! I was only trying to survive!
Lord Ethan. Maester.
You spoke of judgment, Sir Roiland. What judgment is that?
This craven is a deserter and a thief.
This house is doomed!
Oh, shit.
We all fucking know it!
Quiet, thief. Eric was supposed to be guarding our weapons, but instead we caught him stealing them.
Two shields and three spears.
Shit.
Why did you do it?
Because I've no wish to die. Yes, my lord. I fled. We should all flee.
It's not stealing if you're taking what's yours by right.
He speaks truth. He's right.
I've a family to feed. There are not two coins to rub together since Lord Gregor left us to rot here.
Where's our pay?
Our share of bread and wine grows smaller every day.
Leave the poor man alone!
Go.
Lord Ethan, I know these words are hard, but they're honest. This house is falling. We'll never survive the coming winter. Most of us won't even live to see it.
We are in this together.
You say that, but it won't be you who's starving come winter.
You'll address him as Lord. Lord Ethan, you must decide the punishment. Lord Gregor always took a thief's fingers. Three of them.
Now may not be the time for harsh punishment. The men are on edge as it is.
Men need to know they cannot do whatever the fuck they please. Their lord will not permit it.
He's a thief!
We can send him to the war.
Leave the man alone. Show him mercy, my lord. He stole from us.
He deserves
mercy. Make him pay for what he stole.
Give us justice.
Fuck him.
I will decide.
Send him to the war.
Oh, come on.
Take his fingers.
He's a thief!
If you punish me, you'll be punishing an innocent man. It will be an injustice, my lord. Please.
Oh, fuck.
My lord. My family depends on me.
If I show mercy, so many others will think this is okay to flee and lose faith. I send him to the wall.
I sentence you to the wall, where you will join the Night's Watch.
No, please, my lord! My family, without me, they'll die!
That's a hard job being a lord, right?
That was certainly unpleasant, but a lord must mete out punishment when it's due. Not just yourself, of course.
Maester, what do you think?
Me?
Yes. Did I do what's right?
The wall seems like a fitting place for a thief. I only hope he doesn't find Garrett there and take his anger out on the poor squire. You heard what the thief said. I expect this sort of thing will happen again. But a sentinel can help you in the face of disloyalty. You need someone you can trust by your side. Someone you can rely on, no matter the circumstance. Possessing wisdom and experience.
Who do you think I should choose?
There are two capable men for the role. They both want the job, but neither thinks very highly of the other.
How do I decide between them?
Talk to them. Solicit the opinion of people close to you. Here, the bracer of the Sentinel. The badge of office. Tonight is your first small council meeting. It would be wise to bestow this bracer upon your chosen Sentinel then, to show that you are decisive and in control of this house. Your Sentinel will wear this for all to see.
I'll make the right choices, Sentinel.
Come speak with me when you're ready to convene the small council, my lord.
Okay. Oh. Oh, come on. So, we gotta get some information. Okay, guys. I had some... Oh, what's this here? Food? Let's proceed first here. Here's the Maester, but we will speak to him later. Oh, we just... Okay, let's go to the tower. I had some recording problems, so the last episodes, they were kinda shoppy. But it's now solved, and... well...
Slash right! That means now!
Okay... Okay, let's back out. So we gotta speak with the people to make a decision. Come on, let's move here. Let's move out. What's this one? Can I speak with him? No. Food. Look.
Slash and parry! Slash and parry!
Ooh. Our provisions are rather low, my lord. I made the count again, just to be sure. But it doesn't look good.
Has anything gone missing?
No, doesn't look that way. Seems Eric was the only one to resort to thievery. But I'm still worried about our stores. We couldn't withstand a siege, my lord. If the Boltons or the White Hills cut us off and wait us out, we'd only last a fortnight. But there are steps we can take. In the past, we've demanded food from the small folk to replenish our stores. We can do it again, if you'd like. We've done it before in desperate times.
Oh shit, they already...
The last long winter, my family had to give all our pigs to the house. Even if you don't decide now, you may need to soon enough. Until then, I can speak to the huntsmen and trappers. Perhaps they can do more. My lord.
Yeah, huntsmen and trappers. Sounds good. So let's... Just take a look.
Duncan.
Yes, my lord.
Yeah?
I have much to consider and face a difficult decision.
Perhaps I can help. Your father often sought my counsel.
As lord, I must name a sentinel.
Of course. And if I may ask... Who do you favor for the role? Perhaps I can share my insight. And talking can sometimes help you make a decision.
Actually, I wanted to ask, why did you send Garrett away?
I did it for your own protection, my lord. Garrett had to go. By sending him away myself, I thought it would keep you blameless in the eyes of the White Hills. I only hope to give you an advantage.
That's a clever strategy.
I do hope that's a good thing, my lord.
Thank you, Duncan. I appreciate your advice.
I'm at your service, my lord.
Okay, but give praise to? No. Yeah, this way is blocked. Okay, take a look at him.
Do it like you...
Ethan,
Or should I say Lord Ethan?
Hello, Uncle Malcolm.
I saw what you did today. It's not an easy thing to do, showing mercy to a man who admits his guilt. But if you'll excuse me, my lord, I should finish packing before nightfall. I hope to be off tomorrow.
Wait, Uncle. You can't leave. We need you here, especially now.
Your mother asked me to cross the narrow sea to find your brother, Asher.
Asher?
She has asked me to return with him, to help the house.
She said nothing of this to me.
Because she fears you will not agree. I told her my place is here, that I'll be of no help to you in Essos. But she insisted. I will hold, of course, until you've spoken with her about this. Just try to be kind to her. She's been living a nightmare made real. But you know that just as well.
She's my mother. I know how to speak to her.
I'm sure you do.
Okay. But my mother's fears are not the only ones I face. My people are scared as well. I'm told I must choose a sentinel.
If I may be so bold, Sir Roiland is the man for the job. He'd be a fine choice. And I'd trust him.
Why Sir Roiland?
We are at war. You need a warrior by your side. Roiland has the respect of his men and will bring strength and discipline to this house. Duncan would offer sage advice, but now is not the time to negotiate. Not with the likes of Ramsay Snow.
Thank you, Uncle.
Ethan, I need to talk to you. Mother told me Mira has asked for Lady Marjorie's help.
Did she?
I knew we could rely on Mira. She always thinks of family above all else. Hopefully Lady Marjorie's influence will be enough. But right now I'm more concerned about you. I saw what you did to that man. You said you'd get angry sometimes. This would have been a good time to see it.
I can't afford any more mistakes. Everyone knows what happened with Lord Whitehill. Garrett being sent to the wall without my knowledge.
I know. And that wasn't your fault.
I'm the Lord. It's my responsibility. The people want me to lead. They need me to, but...
What? Ethan, please. Tell me.
Who should I name as my sentinel?
It should definitely be Duncan Tuttle. He's dependable and smart, and everyone trusts his judgment. Sir Roiland is unpredictable and likely to make matters worse.
You've always given me good advice. Thank you.
Oh my god. Not a good... Okay. She gave us... He said we should take the warrior. And she, the smart one...
That's what I say,
Parry.
Get that sword out.
Let's speak with Sir Roland. Oh, first take a look.
Come on. What did I say? Swords up. Slash right. Parry. Again. Sword up. Swing left. Parry.
Wrong.
I didn't know Sir dogs could hold swords.
A word?
Of course, my lord.
I have many decisions to make. And I wanted your advice.
Oh.
I need to name a sentinel.
Ah, you do. And it's good you came to me. I know this house, and everyone here knows me. They know I can hold the reins, or wield the sword in equal measure. I'm the man you need. And might I remind you, it was Duncan Tuttle who sent Garrett to the wall. He undermined your authority and made you look weak to the White Hills. I would never do that to you. And if you pardon me saying so, I think your father would be proud, seeing you make good choices as a young lord.
I haven't made my decision yet, but I appreciate your opinion.
So, when will you declare your decision, my lord?
Tonight, at the small council meeting.
Very good. I trust your judgment, my lord.
Yeah, well, guys, one thing which sticks to my mind is to give power to those who don't want it. Yeah. but who is the one I can choose who doesn't want the power?
Are you holding a sword or a turkey leg?
Yeah, come on, take a look at the portcullis. Okay. No one else we can talk to? Ah, come on. Come on, kid, give me some advice. Huh? Ryan.
You're all worthless.
Careful. Keep at it and you won't have much left. Something to pick your teeth with.
No, Ethan. Look at this. All good swords have a name. I call mine Two Brothers. I carved this to give me strength.
Oh.
And this, so I remember. I mean, I could never forget, but... oh, you know, don't you?
And what of your brother Asher? Where's his name?
There's only two sides to the blade. Besides, he left, so... yeah. Someday, I'll have a real one. But not like that one. Only a lord could have that sword.
You'll have a good sword. I'm sure of it.
I watched you today. I saw what you did to that man. Was he our enemy? A bad man? Everyone keeps talking about them. Enemies.
Rules mean nothing if we don't enforce them. It doesn't matter if he's good or bad. You can't steal. That's a rule.
Well, I say he was bad. Bad men killed Father and Roderick. They need someone to hurt them back. Even worse. I want a real sword. No one's afraid of wood. I'll find the men who took Roderick someday, and I'll make sure I have a real sword when I do.
Oh, so eager.
Swords up! You can't lift them, yeah?
Okay. okay. My friend just said I have to take a look at the shield. Okay. Oh, why not? Just take another look. That's a forest. And a sword. Well, okay, there's still one guy we can talk to. The master at arms.
Come on, you dogs! You'll not be fighting.
Can I choose him?
Forever.
I don't think he wants the power. He would be... First, take a look at him. He doesn't want the power. He would be a good choice.
Maester.
Yeah.
Yes, Lord Ethan. I see you've spoken to a number of people. Are you prepared to name your sentinel?
What is it you're doing over here?
Admiring the ironwood, my lord. I studied it at the Citadel. The wood may be black, but I see gold. An entire forest of gold.
What do you mean?
It is our greatest asset, my lord. Why not give some of our ironwood to House Bolton and have them leave us be? We could ransom ourselves. You can hardly put a price on your own life, or the lives of those you love.
A sensible plan, Maester. It may come to that.
I am glad to hear your mind is open to possibility.
Are you holding a sword or a turkey leg?
Yeah, okay. There's nothing else.
My lord, are you now ready to name your sentinel?
Yes, Maester. I'm ready.
Very well. I will convene the small council at once.
At once.
You may sit.
I believe Lord Ethan has reached his decision.
Before I name my sentinel, I must tell you.
Oh.
Duncan, Roiland, this house needs you both.
But you can only choose one, my lord.
Let him be on with it.
Oh, Shit.
Many thought either of you would make a fine sentinel, but I have made my decision.
So, do I have another choice? Give Praiser to Sir Roiland? Oh, fuck. Well, I give it to him. Yeah, to Duncan. He's thinking more with his head, and that's, I guess, important.
Duncan Tuttle, you will be my sentinel.
Tuttle! This is reckless!
Lord Ethan has made his choice.
Yeah!
I will not disappoint you, my lord.
Now, Sentinel, what do you have to report of Ramsay Snow?
Our scouts say he's only a day's ride from here, with no time to waste.
Who knows what he's capable of? We need to prepare for the worst.
We can devise a plan to deal with him.
The Boltons need our people to harvest the Ironwood. Even the bastard Ramsay must understand that.
He's not coming here to negotiate. We must answer with the sword.
That's bloody suicide. You'd gamble with the lives of everyone within these walls. Ignore Sir Roiland. You named me Sentinel. I knew this would happen. He cannot be trusted.
This is the bloody small council.
Enough! Would my father have stood for this kind of bickering? Neither will I.
Enough.
Sir Roiland is clearly able and ready to take up arms, but the rest of our soldiers are not. We need to take a cunning approach. Diplomacy can be a sharper instrument than a sword.
The Bolton sigil is a flayed man. Force is the only thing they understand.
Gentlemen, please. Thank the gods Mira has asked Lady Marjorie for her help. It's not too late for the Crown to intervene on our behalf, but we must have a plan if Mira's efforts are not successful. I trust Mira's judgment. I don't doubt she did everything within her power to help us.
Mother, what do you recommend we do?
We must give him whatever he wants and be done with it. It's too dangerous to do otherwise.
Why not make an offering for peace, my lord?
Yeah, the wisdom of the Citadel.
We can give the Boltons Ironwood in exchange for their protection.
You must be mad. It's pure folly to just give away the only currency we have to bargain with.
Enough! Maester Ortengren has swayed me. We will offer the Boltons a share of the Ironwood, and we will promise our people to harvest it, thus securing their safety.
As Sentinel and Castellan, I must warn against this. You may do this for some gain now, but in the end, it will starve this house.
If we don't, there may be no House Forrester at all.
If you aren't ready for a fight, you're bound to lose when one breaks out.
Ethan has made his opinion known, and you will respect his decision.
Forgive us, my lord. We are, of course, here to serve you, as we served your father.
Aye.
Well then, let's decide how we shall set the stage for Ramsay's arrival.
We could offer him the Ironwood in the courtyard.
My lord, making this kind of offer outright may simply embolden Ramsay. There could be trouble, and all the house will be there to see it. Meet him in the hall. It will be more private, and he will not have an audience to play against you.
Lord Ethan?
I will meet him in the Great Hall.
A wise move, my lord.
It's careless. Can't you see Tuttle is steering you wrong?
That's enough, Roiland. Lord Ethan has given his command.
How many years have I served this house? I cannot listen to that bloody idiot anymore. Forgive me, my lord, but you are not ready to be lord of this house.
Well, fuck off.
You're likely to get us all killed.
Sit down at once.
Apologies, my son. But now that it is settled, we know what we must do. You will meet Ramsay Snow in the Great Hall.
And we will offer the Ironwood, providing a safe future for this house.
And don't worry, Lord Ethan. I will stand beside you, where your sentinel belongs.
Then perhaps we should adjourn. We have to prepare the house.
Oh, this will be funny.
My lord, you have named your sentinel, but you still seem conflicted. And no matter what, you can't be indecisive. Not if you want to help this house. Forgive me.
There will always be those who question your leadership, which is why you need allies you can rely on. Family. Mira has done everything she can in King's Landing, but there are others who can help us. What about your brother, Asher?
Malcolm told me. You want to bring him back.
He's a skilled fighter. But what's more, he has the will to fight. A hunger for it. He always protected you and your sister. And we need all the help we can get.
But won't he be Lord if he returns? Do you want him to take my place?
Of course not. He has no interest in such things. And that's not what I want either. Asher is volatile. But that is his strength, too. Do you remember the Miller's boy? How he tormented you? I wanted to intervene, but your father said Ethan must fight his own battles. But when Asher saw it, he didn't take a breath. He grabbed the Miller's boy by the neck. That was his first instinct. Asher knocked out half the poor boy's teeth. Of course, your father was furious. But you were in danger, and there was nothing else Asher needed to know. Asher does not hesitate. He acts, and we need that. You have many fine qualities. But you do not have that anger inside you.
Asher is dangerous and unpredictable. His presence could help or hurt.
Having another sword at your side always helps, especially now.
He's leaving.
I'm trying to do what's best for this family. What this family needs. Ethan, let me send Malcolm to Essos.
Oh, fuck off. It's not a bullshit decision. Oh, I mean, he will get his brother back. I mean, it's always a good thing to unite the family in dire times. You see? My friend says maybe he is a psycho. Yeah, what the fuck? He's still the fucking brother of the Lord. But he would help. I think it's cool to get his brother back.
Fine. Malcolm will go to Essos and bring Asher back.
Yeah.
Thank you, Ethan. I'm glad you will let me do this. Know that you never stand alone. You are a Forrester. Mira stands with us, and she may be able to help us yet.
Oh, oh, oh. Oh, God. Okay, a strange key. What now? Should we decide if we... What's about just take a look at the key or what? I come on and take it. Yeah, we take it. I think it's more funny to see what is locked. Huh? What's this here? Examine. Oh. Oh no, what the fuck? She could terrible family's seal. Oh no, I won't fake a letter. I won't do this.
Marjorie? Oh. Lady Marjorie is still with the king. I thought you might want to know. Thank you. I thought we were friends, Mira. When you dismissed me the other day, I won't say it didn't hurt my feelings. We've known each other for years, and yet to be treated like that.
We are friends, Sarah. Truly. Friends trust one another. They don't hold secrets. Now Lady Marjorie thinks you don't trust me. And she values your opinion very much.
Sarah, I...
My lady, I'll leave you to talk.
Aww.
Are you all right, my lady?
The king was not inclined to offer help for your family. I'll need this mended.
Gods.
He said I was too easily swayed. And he reminded me that I am not yet his wife. I allayed his fear. For now. But it will be a long time before I can ask him for anything again. Nothing I said could cheer him. He wouldn't even speak to me when I left him.
What can I do to make this better, my lady?
There's nothing you can do, Mira.
Understand, it was my mother's plan, not mine. I just hope you can find some way to forgive me.
This is simply not how things are done, Mira. Not in King's Landing.
I'm sorry, my lady.
Soon I will be queen, and maybe then I'll be in a better position to help you. But for now, we must both be cautious.
I must send a raven. I have to warn my family, if you'll excuse me, my lady.
So...
Milady. Begging your pardon, Milady. I hope I didn't frighten you.
How long have you been waiting there?
Not long. I was just passing by when I saw you emerge from Lady Marjorie's room. I hope you saw. I was right before, about Lady Marjorie and Queen Cersei. I just want you to know, I can help you if you'd like. And your family, if you're willing to trust me. I hear all sorts of things. Things that could be useful for you.
How can you help me? My problems can't be solved by what you might overhear.
Which is why you must trust me, m'lady. You need allies. Hopefully I've proven I can be useful to you.
I'm sorry. I really must go.
Please don't despair. I know people who...
Oh. Who's approaching?
They'd be willing to help you.
So there was the possibility to fake this letter granting House Forrester.
Where's Sir Roiland? He should be here. The man values pride more than honor. We'll do without him.
And without King's Landing. I know you'd hoped Mira could help us, but I'm confident we've enough strength of our own. Your men stand ready to act if needed.
Our plan is a good one. It will work so long as everyone does their part.
Oh, yeah.
Isn't this a lovely pile of timber? Not the place I'd want to be if there was a fire.
Ironwood is near impervious to flame, my lord.
Is it?
May I introduce Lord Ramsay of House Bolton? Son... of Roose Bolton. Although a bastard, Lord Ramsay has the full authority of the
Warden
of the...
Thank you, Lord. That's enough. Who is this little boy? Is he lost?
May I offer you bread and salt, Lord Ramsay?
I loathe bread and salt. Aren't you the little lord? Lord Whitehall told me you were young, but this... Look at you.
A token for the new Warden of the North.
Let me guess. Forrester Ironwood.
Carved by our most skilled craftsman.
Ironwood. Doesn't look like much.
No one can match our skill.
Is that so? Not bad. Lord Whitehill, can your lot do this?
Given enough time, we could learn...
Given enough time, you could do a great many things. But not this, apparently. It seems the Forresters have a talent for something after all.
Oh, fuck!
Lord Ramsay, we have another gift we'd like to offer to you. There are several ironwood groves along the borders of our land, all producing tall, strong trees. We'd like to give them to you in tribute.
To me? That's very kind of you. Thank you.
Oh, shit. Look all bad that. Fucking choices.
More foresters.
Lord Ramsay?
Come out where I can see you.
We really must focus on the business at hand.
What is it you want, Lord Ramsay?
What do I want? Everything. Nothing. We'll see. First, let's see you bend the knee to my father, Lord Bolton, Warden of the North. Words are wind. Anyone can say they're loyal.
Oh,
I want you to show.
God, fuck off.
My lord.
Ha! That wasn't so hard now, was it? Here's the thing. I don't care about your loyalty. And I care even less about a bunch of trees on some far-off hill. The Crown, however, wants what you've got. Whatever you've been supplying the Starks for centuries. Ships, shields, chamber pots. I expect you'll do the same for us. My father has promised as much to the king. You wouldn't want to make him a liar, would you? That wouldn't reflect well on me.
No, Lord Ramsay.
That's a good little lord.
You can't trust a forester. They murdered our men.
It was a forester squire who did it. One Whitehill soldier dead. One Bolton.
He was within his right. They killed his family.
His right? He killed a loyal soldier in my father's army. Then you welcomed me into your hall like a proper lord, hoping I wouldn't linger outside long enough to notice your pathetic little army. That sort of insolence from one of our loyal bannermen will not do. So I've come up with a solution that will benefit everyone. The Whitehills will be taking control of your ironwood from this day forward.
What?
What?
What the ironwood? Fuck?
But...
That is our livelihood.
Then you'd better well find another fucking job.
You can't do that.
Why not? You know something the Whitehills don't? We are talking about trees. You grow them. You cut them down.
The foresters have been tending ironwood for thousands of years. The White Hills had ironwood, once, but now those hills are bare. Do you want ironwood for the next 5 years, or the next 50 generations?
The little lord does have a point. We'll try this. Lord Whitehill will take half of your ironwood, and we'll see who fares better.
But my lord...
Half of something is better... than the nothing you had before. To ensure there's no trouble, Lord Whitehill will install a garrison of 20 men within your walls.
At Ironrath, that we cannot abide. Ethan.
They'll help maintain the king's peace. And make sure there's no more trouble.
This will cause more trouble, not less.
Not for me.
Oh, fuck.
You have a man you trust?
My son, Griff.
Griff will lead the garrison.
You have no right.
White Hills have no place here, lads.
Do make this visit worthwhile.
Please, Duncan, don't.
Look at this, little Forrester. You're not frightened, are you?
Lord Ramsay, please.
And you? Are you Lord Ethan's older sister?
I'm his twin, my lord.
Oh, twins. Like the Queen and her brother. Well, hopefully not just like the Queen and her brother. I never had a sister. Always wanted one.
We have more to discuss, Lord Snow.
I have an idea. You'll come with me. You can be my highborn ward.
Lord Ramsay, that's enough.
Do you like hunting?
Let her go.
She's quite pretty, your sister. We'd get along well.
You've gone too far, Lord Ramsay. I demand you let her go.
I suppose you can stay. Aren't you the brave lord?
What have you done?
But I don't want the brave lord.
Far too much trouble.
Ethan!
Oh, fucking
Ethan!
Shit!
No,
fucking
bastards! No, no.
They can do what they
even
want!
Even though you did bend the knee. I think we've come to an understanding.
Lord Ethan!
I certainly feel better about all this.
What have you done?
However, the Forresters need to keep their end of the bargain. Take the boy as your ward.
No!
Kill him. They give him any trouble.
Brian!
Lovely meeting all of you.
Oh,
we'll
fuck off
again sometime.
Somebody help him.
Fetch the mace so quickly!
You brought this on yourself.
Mama!
Stop!
Don't let him take me!
Let it go!
Stop them!
Help me!
Brian, please!
Stop it!
Let me Bring go! Him Brian! Do something!
Ethan? My son.
He's fucking dead. Now we know the fucking Ramsay Snow. Son of a bitch. Yeah? We need to take the fucking swords. We need to go back and do fucking other decisions. You can't what the fuck?
Ethan sacrificed himself for us all. He saved Talia's life. He'll be remembered as Ethan the Brave.
Fuck off, remember.
This house needs a leader.
Lord Ethan named me Sentinel. I will lead this house.
My sister asked you to swear loyalty to her son, and you did it without flinching.
We can't let them hurt Ryan too. We have to stop them.
We do not stand alone. There are those who will fight for us. Those who hold House Forrester above all other loyalties. Those who will not stop until Ethan is avenged. Until Ryan is home again, our house will not fall. We will be ready.
Nothing comes without a cost, my lady. Are you prepared for what might happen?
Okay. Okay, three-fourths stayed with Bowen and decided not to warn Lord Forrester. And this? Most of them showed mercy or cut the fingers up. Yeah. What the fuck? I think Ethan will die anyway, but it would be very interesting to see what happens if we take up the fucking warrior and just try it. I mean, there's basically no House Forrester at the moment, okay? That's how things should grow on. But anyway, okay, guys, I will do this. I will do another choice of Sentinel. Yeah. And opposing Ramsay Bolton. right from the start. Even though the outcome will be the same, I guess.